Yo, what's up, guys? It's Ethan Dubs here, back with another video, and today. That's right, guys. I'm back, and I'm gonna be posting more often, than one video in 3 months or 4 months, whatever. So today we are going to be doing an ice rink update. It is rainy outside, so it's not gonna be the best rink you've ever seen, but it's gonna be something. So let's go check.
So guys, we are outside right now. Again, it's sprinkling right now, but it was really raining earlier, so it's not gonna be the best drink ever, if I am telling the truth. But here's something. I'll show you guys.
So here's our rink. I can't remember if it's 18 by 9 or something like that, or 20 by 10 or whatever, but it's something close to that. It's in a different spot this year, and we're using some of the same boards that we used last year. And as you can see here, we had to make it a little adjustment there. It's a little bent here with this. We were a little short with this big board here, going from that board right there to this one. So we had to take a 6 foot board, cut it in half, and put it right here. And then we have some props down here to prop it up so that the tarpaulin can actually hold the water. So here is the deepest part of the rink. The only reason I could tell that is show you the more props, and then here it's more level, not really any props except for that board. So this part of the rink facing towards our swing set is the deepest part of our rink, so that's the part that we really have to watch out for if we want to go skating. So this side is the shortest, or not as deep. The water isn't as deep as over there. So this is the shallowest or whatever part of the rink. I can step on it, but water will get on, and I don't want to mess with that, especially since it's one big floating pod of ice right here. So one good thing that we hope will happen, there is actually the polar vortex up in Canada, and it is coming down here to Maine where we live, and it's going to curve the jet stream, so most of the south will get cold air, and the south usually doesn't get cold air to be general or in general. But so we hope that it's cold enough for the rink to freeze down to the bottom of the tarp, which might be thick enough for all of my family members to go skating on it. But yeah, it's a pretty decent rink this year. Again, we moved it from over that area to right here because of it's a little bit more level here than where it is over there. And yeah, so yeah, the polar vortex we hope will do something, but I'll give you one more look at the rink. Here's the sides. It's come up on the bottom, so if I put my hand here, you could actually see the gap from the actual ice here and then water. I could just stick my hand down and feel the tarp. On that side there, I think it might be just water. Let's go check. Nope, it's not just water. There's the big chunk right here. And then again on the sides, there's a gap. Take the leaves out while it's raining. But yeah, it's a little watery down here. And then as I make my way over here, there's a bigger gap with this chunk of ice right here. And then I could just stick my hand down through to the bottom if I wanted to. So yeah, that's pretty much it, except for this area here. It's not frozen to the corner, but here is just one big cutoff. I wonder if I can move this in here. I don't think I can though. And then the shallower end here, the corner, big chunk here. Then that's pretty much it. One thing I do notice here is that when this part usually is up against this tarp here, it's actually come up a little. It's kind of ramped up towards the
tarp. Yeah, guys, that's pretty much going to be the end for this video. Comment some more ideas. Make sure something it's nice in the comment section, unlike my last video. Yeah, comment something nice, or comment video ideas, and I will look at those comments and pick a comment or a video idea, and I will do a video about it. So yeah, more videos coming soon. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.